Good afternoon. My name is Bill Reinhold. I work at the National Cancer Institute, and today I will be describing to you a new web application. This is an introduction to CellMiner Cross Database, a web application for the exploration of cancerous cell lines for pharmacogenomics. Our URL is here. CellMinerCDB makes accessible multiple cancer cell line databases. The institutes that have developed these are shown here on the left. The cell line sets that they've developed are shown on the right. The URLs for each institute are shown here on the bottom. It allows the user to access both drug activity and molecular information from these databases. So this is the information that's currently present. You see there's lots of molecular information for the NCI-60 and lots of drug information. Many more cells for the other cell line databases. The partial overlap of cell lines between databases provides the opportunity for cross comparisons and study augmentation. So see here you see the amount of overlap between each pairing of databases. CellMinerCDB provides multiple functions for integrative genomics and pharmacogenomics, analysis of cancer cell lines. Those are shown here on the bottom, and we'll be going over those individually as we switch now to the web application. So that's shown here. Okay, so we'll start with the univariant analysis page. There's the tab for it, and plot data. So our plot data default input is the gene SCLFN11. We're looking at its transcript expression, and it's being compared to the drug topotecan, its drug activity, both from the NCI-60 cell lines. The resultant scatter plot is shown here. The SCLFN11 expression is on the x-axis, and the topotecan activity on the y. Each dot is a cell line, and this relationship between the two is causal. I'll switch to a second example to say you can see how things work. Now I'm going to the CCLE database. I'm going to change the gene. I'm going to go for the y-axis to the GDSC data set. Going to DNA methylation. Go to the same gene, this is ecadherin. And here's the resultant scatter plot. You can see here the expression of CDH1 on the x-axis, and on the y-axis, the methylation levels. And you get this nice L-shaped distribution, which shows you that as methylation levels go up, expression goes to background. This is epigenetic regulation of a gene that you can demonstrate in this fashion. Something else you can do here is choose which tissue of origins you would like to include. So I'm going to choose brain. And then add on lung. I'm holding down control in a PC and a Mac you would use command. And so you can see, you can get just the tissues of origin of interest to you. So in this example, you can see that ecadherin is mostly off in brain and on in lung, with methylation more influential in brain. For view data, basically displays the data you've chosen in this input on the left and allows its download. So here's the download tab here. Compare patterns, we'll switch back to NCI-60. SCLFN11. And so now what's brought up is the activity levels of multiple drugs. You'll see here there's abbreviations. T1 stand for topoisomerase 1 inhibitors, A7 is an alkylating agent. And if you scroll down, you find many of these kinds of drugs. Further down, you'll find some T2s, which are topoisomerase 2 inhibitors. These again are related causally to this gene, which affects DNA damage drugs, their responses, and these are all DNA damaging drugs. Now we'll switch to the regression models tab. Biologically, regression models are used if one wishes to explore the potential effects of multiple factors on a predictor response. So in the example we'll choose, we'll again stick with the NCI-60. We'll use the drug tip, a TCAN. And then our predictive identifiers will be Schlafen-11, which you just looked at, and BPTF, which is a transcription factor which binds acetylated chromatin. Note that multiple predictors can be chosen, which would have to be the case for a regression model. Either linear regression or lasso machine learning approaches may be selected. In the absence of known predictors, lasso is used. Under the heat map tab here, you're provided with a visualization of both the response and predictor data. So this is the response data here on the first row. The two second rows are the predictor data. The number of visualized cell lines may be varied. That's chosen here. And the names of the cell lines are on the bottom. Data provides the ability to copy or download the response and predictor data. Here's the copy function. Here's the download. Plot provides the actual versus predicted response plot, the correlation, and the p-value. So here's the predicted values on the x-axis, the actual on the y. There's the correlation. There's the p-value. Cross-validation provides the actual versus 10x cross-validated predicted response, an approach used commonly in statistics to assess prediction confidence. Technical details provides the mathematical details for the actual versus predicted response model. So that would be this. Partial correlation functions by hitting this run button. I'll hit it so it'll be calculating. You'll see it's calculating down here on the bottom right. What this does is calculates the highest correlated predictors once the effect of the previous selected predictors are removed. So that is to say, in this case, we have Schlafen-11 and BPTF. Once the effect of these two are taken out, the question is, what gene has the next strongest effect on the topotecan activity? And you'll see in this case, it's brought up a gene called UBB, which is a DNA damage response gene. Well, that makes a lot of sense because topotecan is a DNA damage drug. Metadata allows one to see the databases available for each cell line set and to download any of them. So in this case, you see I have the NCI-60 up here first. By hitting this arrow here, you can see all these different databases are available. If I switch to a different set, say CCLE, you see a different set of databases are available. Each one may be downloaded here at the download data type. The Search IDs tab allows one to search for the available identifiers for any data set. So in this example where I'm looking at expression data, in the gene name, I can put in the famous TP53. And you see all the genes with TP53 in its name are brought up. In the help section, we provide the motivation, background information, descriptions, and illustrations for how to use CellMinerCDB. So for instance, if you wanted more information on how to do regression models, you would click there. And there's a bunch of text here describing what you do, as well as illustrations of how to do it. And so here's the people that have contributed to this project. Let me note specifically Vinod Rajapaksa and Augustine Luna. who are the ones that did the initial work on this. Currently, Fatia Lumi is the one handling the project. If you need help, probably be best to contact either myself or Fatia Lumi. Our emails and phones and whatnot are shown here. Thanks very much for your attention. Please contact us if you have any thoughts on questions you have or potential collaborations. We do expect to try to make some additional videos to give more detailed explanations of some of the more difficult areas of the web application.